Hi students, welcome to the session on boundary conditions in dielectric boundary. Right, so here we take two dielectric medium, two different dielectric medium, right? So this is dielectric one, right? This is dielectric one, this is dielectric two, right? Here it is a boundary, fine. Okay, so this is characterized by permittivity of epsilon 1. This is characterized by permittivity of epsilon 2. Two different dielectrics. As we know, electric field in any medium can be decomposed into tangential component and normal component. So, I decompose the electric field here, right? So, electric field here, this is E1 means. This is tangential component of electric field ET1. This is normal component EN1. Right? Similarly, E can be decomposed means D also can be decomposed. So, this is D1. So, this is a tangential component of D vector. Electric flux density. This is tangential component, normal component of D vector. Right? Similarly, for medium 2, we can decompose. Right, this is E2 electric field at medium 2. This is tangential component of electric field at medium 2. This is normal component of electric field at medium 2. Similarly, we can write for DT1. Okay, DT1. This is D2. Fine? Okay. And I want to find what is the boundary condition in this boundary condition for electric field in this boundary. Right? So, we know that when an electric field extends from two dielectric medium, we are having two dielectric medium. What happens is the boundary between the two medium. This is the boundary. Right? So, the boundary between the two medium, what it will do? It will have an effect on electric field and its component. So, this boundary has effect on this E1 and E2. What is that effect? We will see. Okay. So, first thing is we find electric field due to tangential component. Right. So, tangential component of electric field. So, tangential, let me write properly. So, tangential component of electric field, that is called ET. Right? So, in order to find the tangential component of electric field, we take one small loop like this, right? Whose height is del H. This is del H. Width is del W. Right? What we did for a conductor free space, the same principle we are going to apply. This is del W. Okay? And the loop goes like this, A, B, C, D. So, it is A, B, C, D, right? So, apply conservative electric field rule. We know that for conservative field, E dot dl is equal to 0. So, I split the integration, closed integration into four parts. One is A to, this is closed loop, A to B, B to C, C to D, D to A. So, AB, A to B, E dot DL, right, plus B to C, E dot DL, plus C to D, E dot DL, plus D to A, E dot DL is equal to 0, right, and we have to take as we did in the conductor free space. What is the thing? Del H tends to be 0. Why we are choosing del H tends to be 0? Del H tends to be 0 means the diagram will be like this. It will be exactly tangential. Del H tends to be means del H becomes very, 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 very small. So, the surface will be tangential. I am going to find tangential component 0. So, del H tends to 0 means what will happen? The contribution from BC and AD will be 0 because the height is reduced to 0. So, length DL, DL becomes 0 for BC This is the length. Del H is the length in this direction. So BC and AD will be 0. So BC component will be 0 and AD, DA component will be 0. Right? What we have is only what is that? AD and okay, AD and BC. So what is the only thing? We have only AB and CD component. Right, so these two, this height component will be 0, only AB and CD is having contribution. So closed integral AB E dot DL plus CD E dot DL is equal to 0. Right, so AB, along AB you see it is tangential component, and in this direction electric field will be tangential. You see tangential ET only will be there. So this is ET, right? In this direction, what is the length? DL, ET dot DL vector in the integration. So ET magnitude, ET dot DL is ET DL cos theta. ET magnitude ET, DL is what? Length is del W. So ET del W, angle is cos 0, 1. Similarly, if you come this side, the same ET but in opposite direction. So minus ET del L, same length. So ET del L, again it is angle is 0 between the ET and DL because both are in the parallel. So it is minus ET del omega. Okay, one. So what is the thing? It is top side you see here A is ET 1, here ET 2 because it is second medium, dielectric medium. So what happens from A to B? We can write ET dot DL is ET DL means the width del W, right? ET 1, right? Here it is minus. Why you are putting minus? CD means it is opposite to AB. In that ET is ET 2 del W is equal to 0. This implies ET 1 is equal to ET 2. What is that? The tangential component of electric field in medium 1 is equal to tangential component of electric field in medium 2. That's what ET1 is equal to ET2. That means what? Tangential component is continuous. Same value. Here also same value. At this point, whatever the value here, this will be having here. At this point, whatever the value here, it will have the value here. That's what ET1 is equal to ET2. So that indicates tangential component of electric field is always continuous. Continuous means same and it is producing. ET is equal to ET1 is equal to ET2 means they are having equal value or continuous. Right? At the dielectric boundary. Whereas in conductor dielectric boundary, it is 0. Fine, okay. So this is the first condition. Clear? So ET1 is equal to ET2 means we know D is equal to E by epsilon. So ET1 means D is equal to epsilon E. So I want D, right? So what can we do in terms of D? E is equal to D by epsilon. So DT1 by epsilon 1. For first medium, it is epsilon 1 is equal to DT2 divided by epsilon 2. This implies what we do? What it is indicating? You see, both the materials will have different epsilon 1. Right? Because dielectric medium 1 has 1 epsilon 1, dielectric medium 2 has epsilon 2. Both the values are different, so they cannot be equal. So what is the thing happening here is DT1, right? So that is tangential component of D, right, is discontinuous. Because E1, E2 may be different. So it is discontinuous. Okay, now we have to find normal component of electric field. That's what En. So similarly, what we did for free space conductor boundary, we take what you call one pill box, right? So we take a pill box, Gaussian pill box like this, right? This height we call del h. The surface of the top side is del s, bottom side is del s, okay? And here dn1, dn2, right? Okay, now we will apply as usual Gauss law and make del h tends to be 0. Why del h tends to 0? Then only it will become like a cylinder of this shape. It is where we find normal. If you are taking this one, it is for understanding purpose. I want this shape should be closer to the boundary, not big one. So then we find a normal component. This is the shape, this is the normal component. That's why del h tends to 0 we have to take. Okay, so what we are going to do? We will apply Gauss law to the pill box. So apply Gauss law to pill box. Right, for example, you see it is like this, right? Our pill box will be like this. Right, here D1, D2. Right, fine. This is a del s value. This is a del s value. Del h tends to be 0. Fine. So, what is that? I can apply d dot ds equal to q. That's what of Gauss law. Right, q enclosed. So, instead of this loop, we take d dot ds in top side, then d dot ds in bottom side, then d dot ds in other sides. Because it's a surface integral, right? So that is equal to q enclosed. Fine. Okay. Now you see, right? Both are dielectric, right? So what we are going to do? Let us see that. First thing is del h tends to 0 as usual because I have to take a normal component. For that, the shape should be point. So what is that? This side area. Not top we have made 0, bottom we have made 0. Only this cylinder will becoming like this. So del s tends to 0 means side area becomes 0. So we can neglect this side area. Okay, so it will be 0. Right, so what happening here? So we've come to the things. We have only top d dot ds plus bottom d dot ds, right, is equal to, okay, bottom is equal to q enclosed. Let us assume if there is no charge, this will become 0, right? So for no charge in boundary, no charge in boundary means q 0, no charge in boundary. Okay, so what is d in the top? You see, top means what is the thing? We know normal component will be in this direction. Area is also in the same direction, so angle between d and ds, it is dn direction, right? Dn, normal vector of electric flux will be this side, this is tangential component. So dn is in this direction, area is also in this direction, so the angle between d and ds 0. So mod a dot b is equal to a b cos 0. What is b? It is area. Ds is area. That is given by ds. So d into ds. This is looking up. This is looking down. So it must be same but minus. That's it. So what is happening? So I can write top one. We have, what is the d value? dn1. What is area? Del s. Similarly, bottom one, dn2 del s. But it is opposite to top one. So that is equal to 0. Okay, so now what happens? Dn1 is equal to dn2 if q 0, right? This implies En1, d is equal to E by epsilon naught, En1, okay, let me write properly. Dn1 is equal, d is equal to epsilon E, right? So I can write d1 is E1, epsilon 1, epsilon 2, En2. So what is the ratio? So En1 divided by this epsilon 2 I bring this side, that is equal to En2 divided by epsilon 1, right? This is what my boundary conditions for normal component. This implies En1 divided by En2 is equal to epsilon 2 divided by epsilon 1, right? If charge is not zero, what would happen? Right? If Q0, it is the answer. If Q is not zero, what would have happened? dN1. Here I put Q0. If it is not Q0, dN1 del S minus dN2 del S equal to Q. Right? Del S you take dN1 minus dN2 is equal to Q by del S. Charge per area is, what is that? Surface charge density. Charge per surface area, surface charge density. dN1 minus dN2 is equal to rho S. Charge per area, charge density, surface charge density, because it is del S. So that's what we have to remember about this one. So condition is, hope you understand the condition, right? So if Q0, the electric flux density is continuous. If not, it is discontinuous. That's what we are understanding from this. So normal component of electric flux density is continuous if Q0 in dielectric interface, right, is if is discontinuous if Q is not equal to 0 at the boundary, right? So this is what dielectric boundary conditions. I hope understand things clearly. If you have any doubt, please ask me in comment section. Thank you.